The Minister of Work, Dave Umahi, said that the federal government had devised means to hasten the completion of the road project, which was awarded since 2012 but could not be completed. He disclosed that the federal government had agreed to BOA's commitment to construct 30 kilometers of the road under the credit tax scheme, after which a tax certificate will be awarded to the company. The minister added that three other contractors will be mobilized for the construction of the remaining 30 kilometers. Engineer Umahi stated that four contractors will handle the four sections of the road. The first section from Lokoja is being handled by CGC, the second section is being handled by Mothercat, the third by Dantata, while the last section is handled by ROCC. The minister gave a brief history of the project, stating that it was first awarded in 2012, yet the last administration later reviewed the project to 879 billion naira under the Nigerian National Petroleum Company Tax Credit Scheme. However, he added that the cost of the project is different from the commitment of NNPC, because NNPC's commitment was just 122 billion naira, and so there was a funding gap of 775 billion naira, and he did not see where that money was coming from.
I just came back from the road, yeah. And we had a number of agreements.
The minister revealed that all he did when he came on board was to keep the project but review the texture of the pavement by allowing the existing carriageway to be asphalt and then review the new carriageway to be concrete. Umahi said that the ministry would mobilize the contractors after signing an addendum to collect 30% fund to fast track the project, amounting to 9 billion naira each. He, however, said that the contractors would do an affidavit agreeing on the timing for completion of the project, and that the Ministry of Work is very serious about the timing of the project and appealed to the contractors to be diligent and committed, working according to the timetable.
The stake here is the road from Lokoja down to Benin, where we have four sections.
Responding, Mr. Kabiru Rabiu, Group Executive Director, BOA Group, said the company was committed to supporting the administration of President Bola Tinubu to succeed. According to Rabiu, in Edo alone, BOA made an investment of over $2 billion with five lanes of cement. He said that the construction of the 30 kilometers road was also in favor of the group as well as the people of Edo, and added that the company is committed to make the necessary investment under the tax credit scheme in return for a tax certificate.
Well, to make the necessary investment under the tax credit. You know, this is money that BOA is, you know, putting, you know, to do this road.
Earlier, Senator representing Edo North Senatorial District, Senator Comrade Adams Eric Oshomole, commended President Bola Tinubu-led administration for responding swiftly to the needs of the people. According to Senator Oshomole, Edo State residents had been lamenting over the deplorable state of the road for the past 2 to 3 administrations. He said that some of the contractors were not serious with the project, while some totally abandoned it. Senator Oshomole said several appeals were made to previous governments who made promises but were not kept. So they cried to the president, and that they are happy that through the intervention of the minister, the president has given them a listening ear. Senator Oshomole stated that he was shocked that within 72 hours, the minister swung to action. The problem that the ministers before him could not solve got a swift answer.
We are happy that through the person of the Honorable Minister, the president has given us a listening ear.
On his part, the senator representing Edo Central Senatorial District and APC governorship candidate, Senator Monday Okpebolu, said President Tinubu succeeded in rekindling hope in the people of Edo through the road project. He added that if this is how Nigeria works, everybody will want to come back home, and that nobody will want to leave the country, and that it is an excellent move for Edo people.
I'm happy that this is done. It's an excellent move for Edo people.
Senator Monday Okpebolu concluded by saying that with the project and other laudable initiative of President Bola Tinubu, the APC will win the governorship election in Edo State in clean slate. Best Orator, reporting for BTV News.